How's your rehearsals gone? Good?
They're great.
The orchestra sounds great.
Yeah?
Yeah, the band not so much, but the orchestra's awesome. Four of us.
There we go.
Four of us rock clowns are going to ruin the whole thing.
Just pull up a chair and just watch them.
Well, I kept kind of being, you know, distracted because I'd be like, oh, I'm supposed to sing here. I don't really want to sing because I just want to watch the orchestra.
Oh, really? It just sounds that good.
Yeah, it's great. You know, it's just that symphonic sound that adds so much.
Yeah.
This is probably almost a year in the making, I think, from the time that it was actually mentioned to coming to fruition. And a once-in-a-lifetime experience, and we get to do it twice, which is really cool. Mark and Miles and I came to see a show here about 10 years ago when we were staying down the street doing some press for, I think it was the Blackbird record, if I remember right, and got to come here and just see the beauty of this place and the acoustics of the room and just everything. It's unlike anything we've ever played before.
You know, our manager, Tim, it's kind of his brainchild. And he dreamt it up. I'm not gonna lie to you, he dreamt it up.
It was November 24th of 2016 that the guys were playing the O2 Arena. And I just kind of brought it up, said, hey, I have this idea. It's gonna sound crazy, but hear me out.
Tim Turnier, our manager, said, what do you think about doing, you know, doing a show with an orchestra?
Right as he uttered the words, I was just like, oh man, that's a no-brainer. People before the show were like, oh, aren't you nervous? We did an interview, and said, like, you guys are gonna be so nervous for you going. Actually, it wasn't that way. I mean, it was actually very, I remember standing at the side of the stage right before we started with Slip to the Void, just kind of having this zen moment and feeling like everything was going to be all right. I don't know what it was. I think once again it goes back to those fans. I think when I looked out, saw a lot of familiar faces, people we'd seen from all over the world, it felt like we were just going in to play a show in front of our family. I think out of all the years of doing this, this experience is top two or three highlights without a doubt, maybe even number one. So it's something that none of us are going to forget.
Slip to the void, to the dark, to the fall. Crawl to the life you shouldn't know. You should never come this way to test the hands of fate. You don't belong here. Peel back the skin. Close your eyes, hell is born. To the abyss, but be warned. You feel what you've become. My God, what have you done? You don't belong here. But it's all in your way. You touch and you obey. Denial. But it's all in the way you touch and you obey. Denial. Through.
Good evening. Wow. Look at this. This is great. This is wonderful. This is wonderful. Look at this. Right here. Right there. That's what it's all about, right there. That's what tonight's all about.
None of us had ever done anything like this before. And, you know, that night, I don't think that Alter Bridge was four guys. I think it was 60 people. And it was, that's what it took. Everyone working together, everyone from Joey Bruckman, our front of house, who did an amazing job, to Joe Eager, our lighting guy, you know, Matt, our engineers, to, you know, Ian and Eddie and Frosty, all of our techs, like everyone was firing on all cylinders, and that is what made the show. You know, those are the unsung heroes.
Growing up, I listened to a lot of Beatles and a lot of bands from the UK and England, and had seen a lot of interviews about, you know, them performing here, and you know, for this to come to fruition and to be a part of it, man, it's just it's very nostalgic. I mean, it's been a lot of planning, a lot of things have over the last year, you know, going into this, playing a lot of songs that we haven't played really together live at all, some of them. You know, we worked a lot in rehearsals and you know, there's a lot of, it's just a lot of moving parts, you know, getting the orchestra and Simon and Will and just all the people that have been involved with this whole process, you know, it's just to make it all happen and to see it all come to light, you know, it's been just really cool.
This kind of show is not, it doesn't normally get done, and there's a reason for it.
Yeah.
The reason being is it's absolutely outrageous, and you need people who are basically willing to completely just devote themselves to something for months and months at a time in order to make it happen.
You know, at first, we spoke with a few different people. You know, I reached out to a couple different conductors and trying to find the right fit, and it was by, you know, suggested of a friend that I came across Simon, and Simon then connected me with Will. Instant trust, you know, I was like, okay, these guys get it. They get the vision. They know what we're doing. And we just had like a, just kind of a loose conversation at first. And they both started coming back with the same songs that I was already thinking in my head. It's like, okay, we have something. And then, you know, you get back this music score, and not everybody can read a music score, so it's, you know, let's program what this audio is actually going to sound like and then present it to the band. So that's what we did, and I think that's when they were like, whoa, this could be real, and it actually sounds really unique and amazing.
You know, he would send a batch of 3-4 at a time, and we'd have a listen, and it's really, it was hard to gauge at that point because it really wasn't what it was in rehearsals. You know, it's kind of hard to gauge how it's going to be when you're all together, you know, and it's the same when we're writing together as a band, you know. So yeah, we were, you know, sent a lot of things ahead of time, and for the most part, I mean, it was always spot on. You know, we ever really sent any changes or anything that we wanted. So Simon's been incredible.
So we're going to imagine for now, before we're to click, that this first bar is going to be a bar of 4-4, which is just a tam-tam. So it'll be 1-2-3-4, 1-2-3-4, first double bar.
You know, most of the tracks, there's no pop bangers. You know, there's like, they're 7-minute tunes. So it was like a lengthy process. We know the tunes pretty well.
I was chipping it away at it, and I think Andrew was chipping away at it as well, but you did 12.
I was locked
away. I remember there was about a month when you were sending me a tune like once every 2 or 3 days.
Yeah, I was...
like continuously.
It's in 16-hour days.
Yeah, yeah.
That's the hardest part, really, because, you know, and then it's got to be signed off, so you could do all that work and they could go, actually, we don't like that. But, you know, they're cool guys, and I think we pitched it pretty well, so, like, yeah, it's cool.
I think from the very moment we heard it, we loved it. You know, it was... I thought it was going to be a daunting thing to sit down and take each song and be like, you know what, this oboe's doing something I don't like, or this violin's doing something I don't like, and it was never the case. I think after you hear a couple songs, you're like, let's let them have their artistic vision. Nothing stuck out to us ever, and it was all just beautiful and beautifully done, and it took a lot of the load off of us.
I think we all knew that, you know, it was really going to be next level as far as what they were going to add to what we do. But to sit back and hear songs that are 10 years old and just hear those extra parts, you know, be added to it, it was an emotional journey, you know, to hear something that's been your baby for so long and then watch it grow up, I guess.
It looks like we have people that have flown from all over the world, from what I'm saying right here. Is this correct? All over the place. This is great. This is This is Crab Achilles.
Thank you. Tomorrow is not tomorrow.
Thanks for all you've done. I've missed you for so long. I can't believe you're gone. You still live in me. I feel you in the wind. You guide me constantly. I never knew what it was to be alone, Lord. 'Cause you were always there for me. You were always waiting. But now I come home, I miss your face so. Smiling down on me, I close my eyes to see, and I know you're a part of me, and it's your song that sets me free. I say it wild, I feel I can hold on, I sing tonight. 'Cause it comforts me. Ooh.
That's right.
I carry the things that remind me of you in loving memory of the one that was so true. You were as kind as you could be. But even though you're gone, you still mean the world to me. I never knew what it was to be alone, no. 'Cause you were always there for me. You were always amazing. But now I come home, it's not the same, no. It feels empty and alone. I can't believe you're gone and alone. You're a part of me, and it's your song that sets me free. I'm glad it sets you free from sorrow. I still love you more tomorrow. And you'll be here with me still. What a day you did with feeling. And you always found a meaning. Yeah, you always will. Thank you.
Everything is gone. Yeah, I've seen it all. I've seen it all.
Thank you so much. So here's the deal. We're gonna we've never played anything this cool or formal before. So apparently the protocol is that we're gonna take a 25 minute. We take a 25 minute break now. So you guys go do your thing. We're gonna do our thing. Brian's gonna go practice his miming and his yoga, and we'll be right back to rock with y'all. Thank you so much. This has been awesome so far. Thank you.
When we had the first rehearsal, I was, you know, 2 days prior to the actual gig, I was excited but nervous because it was kind of a massive undertaking, and all we had to really gauge things from were these little demos. I don't even remember what the first song was, just being like, oh my God, give me the hair. In fact, at the first day of rehearsals, I was getting goosebumps so much. The hairs on my, you know, back of my neck were standing up so much that my skin was sore. I mean, it was just as a songwriter, you know, those sorts of things are such a high.
Most of us, Mark doesn't, but the rest of us, we're in-ear monitors, and we can control what comes in and what doesn't come in. And I think at first we were all like, crank the orchestra, and then halfway through the rehearsal realized like I was missing fills and stuff because I was concentrating, I was listening to what they were doing.
Here's the problem. I don't want to sing, I just want to watch you guys. So can I do that? Our drummer will sing. You want to sing?
When I heard the word orchestra, I thought it was going to be, you know, kind of very older, very proper, whatever the term is. Not that the Parallax Orchestra isn't, but there's an element of hipness there, which, so even just, I'm talking from a visual standpoint. When I walked in the room, I go, this is cool. This isn't like stuffy or anything. This is hip. And Simon is a total rock star. I mean, the way he's got this thing that you just, is very compelling.
Simon knocked it out of the park. I think he's, like Miles said on stage, he's a rock star. He's a brilliant man, and at some point we'll work together with him again. So I think that's a guarantee.
Without having the Parallax Orchestra behind us, it's going to be very lonely. Our booking agent, John Jackson, he brought that up after the show. He's like, so Miles, what are you going to do when you look back and the orchestra isn't there? And I was just like, man, I don't, that's a good question. I never thought about that. Maybe we'll try and get like a bunch of cardboard cutouts and stick it back there just to make us feel better.
We're gonna have to up our game a little bit, you know, because it was all just pure magical between the crowd, between the orchestra, between ourselves and the mix, between the whole room. It just felt like everybody was one big cohesive unit. Even the speaking with everybody in the orchestra, they had, some of them said, the best night of their lives, and you could look back and see them really digging into their instruments. You know, I'd love to see the passion and people when they play, and they were all going for it. So, and we all had said at the little after party we had that everybody's just dying to do it again. So.
Control. Let me go on, I'm free. Well,
All right. Well, I think we're almost. You guys ready?
Let's do it.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, let's do it.
Having the full vision of what it needs to be, yeah. Getting that all in place without ever having my band meet these other 41 people that they're going to be making music with until 2 days before the biggest show of their life was stressful, to say the least. Felt like the weight of the world was on my shoulders, for sure. And I remember we got into that room, you know, we rented a warehouse, set up the stage, set up everything, and the very first song that they played was Slip to the Void. And it starts off with the drone, and Miles is singing, and the orchestra starts, and you just kind of feel it. And I'm like, okay. And then there's the part where, you know, Flip does his count, and then the whole band comes in. And it's the first time they go to do the count, they all go to come in, and it just doesn't happen.
That would be bad.
And we crash.
Flips goes, all right, do it again. And then you're running through the same motion again, and I have this knot in my chest and in my stomach, and then it goes to have the band come in, and it clicks and it connects, and the band's there, the orchestra's there, and then you're just like, thank God this is gonna work.
It's awesome. Really good. It's awesome. My hairs are standing up on my arms, so that's good. Really good.
People might think we rehearsed the hell out of this, but we rehearsed each song maybe once with the orchestra. And then we went back over counting in every song and making sure that we're all starting at the same time. Because that could have been the biggest factor that could destroy the performance. Everybody had to know when to come in. And from there, we just play it through. But we thought we would go into rehearsals and play through this set multiple times each day. But we really only got through it once. So thank goodness it turned out the way it did.
Chase the city.
drinks on as we outrun our off of agony. Alright, let's hear it. Come on.
Thank you so much. Wow. You guys are the fucking best. You are the best. You're the best. You've been so good to us for so long. We'll be right back.
found the summer days. We were young and unafraid. With innocence we glide beneath the stars. This is so long ago, beyond the love that all now know. Before the years would hold their way and break my heart. So you found the time for what once remained. Yesterday is gone, we can't go back again. So you
Tim had mentioned it once when he brought it up, and he liked the whole future song concept that Celine and I and a few others back in Spokane, where I live, had started a few years ago. Basically, it's to get musical opportunities, be it instruments or private instruction or whatever, to a child who wants that and doesn't have that. The home that just doesn't have the financial means or whatever the situation is, our goal is to make it so they have that option and they can have those opportunities. A lot of it is because of the fact that you have this orchestral element as well. So I think that was it's not just about the rock, you know, the big bombastic rock and roll band, but also you have the very traditional element of woodwinds and brass and percussion and all that, which is, it felt like it just kind of rounded out the whole musical smorgasbord. So if you're a kid and you want to play trumpet, or if you're a kid and you want to play guitar, if you're a kid and you want to play, a woodwind instrument, I think that this was just it just felt right. Just felt like a real good fit. So we're very glad we're very happy with how that whole thing turned out as an organization, for sure.
Thank you so much. How was your break? Was it good? You guys have a good time? I'm chilling out, waiting for our asses. So I just want to point something out real quick. Some of us have an organization that we started, and basically the premise of the organization is to try and, any kid that wants to play music, we want to help them out. So it's called the Future Song Foundation. And a portion of this whole event is going to the Future Song Foundation. And and it's actually really appropriate that we're having the opportunity to play with these guys, because as we've started rehearsals, you know, when you guys are tuning and whatnot, it takes me back to when I was a kid. And my mom, actually, she's the one that really, at the time, as a 10-year-old, pushed the issue. She wanted me to play a musical instrument. So I was lucky because my mother got me into band. And so hearing you all play reminds me of that incredibly empowering experience that is music at a young age, how important it is. And it's hard for me to fathom, and it's frustrating to know there are kids out there that want to play, that can't play, that can't get instruments or instruction. So we're trying to, if you want to play, there's a way. So futuresongfoundation.org, check it out. Mom, I love you. Thanks for coming to the show. My mom is the best. She's the best. This is called The Last Hero.
We'll be right back.
there's a lot of these songs that aren't in our normal set list, and it just seemed appropriate for these type of, you know, the Words Darker Than Their Wings and Last Heroes and Fortress and all these longer, more epic type songs that, you know, having an orchestra behind us would really just take those songs to the next level and give something, you know, fans that have been seeing us for years and years and years, something special, you know, as much for them as it is for us.
We're the ones that we need, you know, like the ones we're not, that we don't normally do.
I thought Words Darker was awesome.
I'm still really nervous about it.
Why?
It's just, I don't know what it is. It's just, I think it's because I just know all the parts that are missing, and it just, from where I'm standing, it's just like, I just want to go to sleep.
Really?
Yeah, so maybe it'll help. I want to hear it with it. I want to go and hear what's going on with those guys. Yeah. Yeah. Words sounded awesome. Yeah, maybe just my mix.
That's actually one of my favorites.
Yeah.
What's that?
So yeah, it could just be my mix then, if you guys are all cool with it, because from where I'm sitting.
Thanks very much.
Thank you.
We're going to get through it all, but
we'll get through tomorrow.
Sort of thought we might not.
Yeah, yeah.
There's a lot to do, but smash through the rest tomorrow, top and tail, work it all out.
Great.
As long as you guys are feeling happy and
confident. It's great.
Stuff,
yeah, it's great.
I think it's going to sound.
Yeah, I think you guys sound awesome. We still have some things to work through amongst the four of us, but yeah.
We'll make sure they're all leveled out.
Okay, great.
But have a good day.
Awesome. Good job.
Yeah, good job, man.
Fantastic.
Thanks, Simon.
All right.
Words Darker Than Their Wings was a song that we've never played before, ever. And it's been one of our favorites, especially me and Scott Phillips. That's been one of our top three Alter Bridge songs since we wrote it. And it's just one of those songs that we've been trying to play live, and you know, Miles was always kind of pushing back about it, and finally, you know, with this orchestra, he said, you know what, this is the perfect time to do it, and we did it, and it was the biggest reaction of both nights.
Okay, so we have a special treat for y'all, and there's a song that we've had in our catalog for, when was this made? 7 years, something like? It's been around for 7 years. We recorded it on AB3. And fans have been asking for a long, long time, when are you going to play this one special song? It's this one song. And these guys are like, oh, you know, Miles doesn't want to play it because whatever, it's just a high note at the end. He's a big baby. So, I'm gonna man up. I'm manning up. You guys wanna hear Words Darker Than the Wings or what? Okay. All right, let's do this.
Just see.
Thank you so much. You know, the problem now, here's what's really messed up, is we're probably going to have to start playing that song in the set on a regular basis. But wait. Now, if we're to do that, I think that the stipulation should be that these guys should tour with us all the time. That's what I think. Just my personal opinion. Because they're bad ass. That's right. Awesome. They elevate the songs and make them much better than they were to begin with. So good. So good. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to introduce to you my friend, the man, the myth, the legend. Please make some noise for Mr. Mark Tremonti.
If you deny the wounds of your lover, you will discover how that what you had is shattered and wasted. Did you have to take it so far? Exposed in lover's devour, and the ivory tower is coming down. A vow betrayed and honor is broken, and the wounds are open and bleeding out. But it's warm, the chamber is loaded, lost in a moment, what went wrong? There's nothing left, this house has been broken, but still I'm holding on.
Yeah! We'll be right back.
what made this show special. It was the show that also our friends and family flew all the way in. You know, I had my wife and kids, and Brian had his father and his brother, and Miles had his parents and his brother, and it's everybody. Nobody usually flies out to see us unless it's one person here or there, and it's never one big event that everybody flies to, and this was that event.
To have all of our families here, it's kind of calming too, you know. It's kind of like, oh, family's here, you know. And go get that little hug, and it's gonna be all right. You know what I mean? So yeah, it's special. It's a big moment for, you know, and the family and friends are here from the States, and fans from all over the world have come, you know.
No, it was just one of those perfect moments, you know. It was even coming off stage and seeing all the faces, you're like, you remember, oh, you were here and you were here. I'm glad these people got to experience that. I'm glad I didn't have to go home and explain to my wife how great it was. You know, you had to be there, you know. And you know, I even had my brother Mike, who was in Chicago, call me this morning, and he's like, you know, he does a lot of our social media stuff, and he's like, man, it just seems like everybody said it was the best show they've ever seen at Alter Bridge do. And in explaining it to him is not good enough, you know. He can't watch it on YouTube and get the full feel of it, you know. So hopefully you know, we've captured enough of it to get it close to the real thing.
You know, my mother and father, was the first time, you know, my wife and I wanted them to fly over. So, and my brother and my guitar instructor when I was a kid was there, who's also on the Future Songboard. And then, you know, these diehard fans. It just felt like kind of stepping on stage in front of, I was as if I was going to perform in my living room. Not that my living room is anywhere near as beautiful as that venue, but it really was just a very, there was a certain amount of peace that I felt. It was a beautiful, beautiful two nights for sure. All right. You guys having a good time? You guys all right? Way up top. We feel you. Let's feel you. Come on. There we go.
And I want you to know I've loved you. wonderful life. What a wonderful life. What a wonderful life. What a wonderful life.
Thank you very much. The Parallax Orchestra, ladies and gentlemen, make some noise! Thank you.
this side of fate, this blind. The choice has been made, it's time. For all that we've done, will we ever choose to say? The fault of our own, the same we must resist. This must resist. We'll be right back.
When you feel like you've, all the planets are lined up and everything is going as you hoped it would, and then you see that reaction, you see the effect that the music has on people, and you see the tears, and it's incredible. I mean, it's incredible, and it just makes you, it really makes you realize what an incredible art form music is. What a wonderful life, for as long as you've been at my side, and I want you to know I love you so. It's such an honor to see, you know, when somebody comes and says, I'm from Israel, or I'm from Poland, or I'm from Russia, or I'm from Australia, New Zealand. We had every people from all around the globe there at this show. And it's not just people from the UK or from America. I mean, it's from all over the world. I mean, I see all walks of life out there. From a demographic, it's full spectrum. And that's when I just kind of revel in the power of music. It's just so universal. It's a universal language.
It's mind-blowing. And I mean, you know, you see the social media, we've got fans in Israel and India and Alta Bridge, Brazil, and Alta Bridge, Peru, and it's like, you know, just I hope that we can get to those countries eventually and hopefully be able to reach that fan base.
It really goes to show, you know, we have such an appreciation for it, is how diverse and dedicated our fan base is, and that there's people that have come to this show that we've seen all year that fly all around the globe to join us on this journey that we're on, and it's really special for us, and it just blows us away that we've got people that appreciate what we do that much.
It hits me and emotionally really pulls my heartstrings, because it, you see what degrees people will go. I mean, there are people who travel 30 hours to see those shows, and then you feel the love from them, and you see how much they appreciate it and what the whole interaction means to them. And, you know, it really hits me, and you can see it at times during the show that I told myself I wasn't gonna do it, but it was hard not to get a little emotional at times. You know, I don't like to be the guy standing on stage, you know, trying to keep it together, but I'm human, and when you're feeling that sort of, whatever, I don't even know how to articulate what that is. It's hard for me to articulate, because it's just so beautiful and so real, and it's just, it's like, gosh, it sounds freaking cheesy, but there's just this haze of love that we feel from them, and it's the reason that we keep doing this. I mean, it's when you're standing on stage and you're feeling all of that, it reinforces it, and it makes the four of us very grateful.
Stands a face. From a distance is calling your name, and
furl your black wings and wave. Across the horizon, it's coming to sweep you away. It's coming to sweep you away.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. This is a... you've been so good to us for so long. Thank you. You're amazing. We're lucky. We're very lucky. Thank you. I want to thank the powers that be that helped us put this whole thing together. I want you guys to make as much noise as you can. First of all, is the brainchild of this guy. I want you to make some noise for our manager, Tim Turnier, ladies and gentlemen. This was his brainchild. You're the man. Get out here. Get out here, you punk-ass kid. Get out here. He didn't think I'd do that. We'd like to also thank Andy and everybody at Live Nation. We want to thank John Jackson and all K2 for helping book us in this place. Amazing. And Well, once again, we have to thank the Royal Albert Hall for letting us, hitting this long hair in here. But, I mean, I'm here really, and I think you guys would agree, this is really ultimately about these beautiful people right here. So I want you to make some noise for the Parallax Orchestra. Stand up. The rock star conductor, Mr. Simon Dobson, make some noise. William Harvey, where are you, buddy? Come out here. Awesome. Thank you so much, man. There you have it. What do you say we play one more song?
today, but how I know the sun will fade. As darker days seem to be what will always live in me. Instead I run. It's hard to walk this path alone. Hard to know which way.
Thank you.
Thank you.